All right, the upgrade to my portable MPCNC electronics is now finished. I put that in quotation marks because I'm sure there'll be changes, but some things, most important thing I did was I am using much bigger stepper motor drivers, and you can see I put a fan in the bottom there that's sucking air from underneath the enclosure. I'm using 40 volts, 224 volt power supplies in series that are controlled by this Rui Dang device, which is nice because it shows me the voltage and current and the power levels, and I can set all sorts of overcurrent protection on that. The other big change is that it's being now controlled by a teensy 4.1, which is on Phil Barrett's breakout board there, and that goes much, much faster. It can send out faster steps to the stepper motors. And also I made the fuse box much easier to get into if I need to make changes. And I got the emergency stop switch hooked up to feed hold now. That's kind of handy. I'm using IO sender as the controller program, and it's communicating to this control box through Ethernet, which leaves the USB port of the teensy available for talking to my pendant. Here's a prototype that I'm making for a pendant that has a rotary encoder and a joystick, and it's going to be wireless, and it's going to be talking to an ESP32 that will plug into this socket here through ESP now. You can also see the upper ESP32 there has temperatures. I installed temp sensors on all of the stepper motor drivers. Okay, we're going to see how fast it goes now. I previously did some drawing tests, which came out pretty good, but using these pen holders didn't really work too well. This pen holder I designed for Sharpies, and it has a lot of play in it. So when I made a drawing with that, it really came out pretty bad. This is the PLA plastic pen holder that is from V1 Engineering's website, where the MPCNC plans are. So let's get those out of the way and then hit start. And then you better get every body part out of the way because it goes very fast. Okay, here we go. So first it's going to do a lot of drawing of letters. Those letters are 3 millimeters tall, as it says there, and they're coming out very good now that I've used the spindle motor as the pen holder. So I'll pause this for a while and come back to you when it's done with the lettering. Probably one of the most significant improvements is the speed at which this thing can move in the Z direction. So thanks to faster pulses coming to the stepper motor here, this Z axis can really move fast. And that allows me to do something like this lettering where it's constantly going up and down and up and down quite a bit faster. Now we're going to draw a few circles. Come out nice and round. Wow, look at that. Woo! And the join between the two ends of that ellipse came out perfect. That was traveling at 200 millimeters a second. Wow. So I use this big rectangle to calibrate the thing, make sure that the axes are square to each other, and they are now. And you can tell by when all these lines intersect in the middle. we go. Pretty good. Wow, look at that. That's amazing.